respectively. It does raise a question. How should countries, both developed and developing, plan in order to avoid this sort of natural disaster causing such havoc in future? Margareta Wahlström is the UN Special Representative for Disaster Risk Reduction. She joins us now from Geneva. Margareta Wahlström, do you believe there are lessons to be learned from what we've seen and heard from Brazil, Sri Lanka and Australia right now?
Yes, I think you've seen an illustration of all the main issues. It's early warning, it's preparedness, it's public awareness and education, it's the quality of infrastructure, and it's the very rapid evolution of urban areas. The president of Brazil mentioned the issue of land use planning, of urban planning, drainage that allows rapid water to take off. But we also this year, and I think that is maybe really the main learning here, is these are extreme weather events that we see. This year partially caused by La Niña and El Niño, a well-known phenomena that doesn't happen every year regularly. But you know, the trend over the past decade or so, it's really that the frequency of these type of extreme events is increasing and is getting more severe, even if it's not every year. So the cost of improving the infrastructure, the education, and making this investment is a development investment. It's an issue of building resilient societies and long-term sustainability.
Yeah, I'm interested you talk about urbanization there. Clearly in Brazil in particular, there is a question mark about why towns and so much housing was put into mountainous areas where landslides, frankly, are quite a frequent occurrence. The president suggested there is a problem there with illegal building. How do you address that in a society like Brazil?
I think, it's not just an issue of stating the obvious, because people want to live in cities. Cities offer jobs, modern life, education, and even poor people tend to have better lives and opportunities in cities. So Latin America, in fact, has the fastest growing urbanization rate globally and have an enormous amount of people coming to urban areas. So I think it's the lesson learned really is that governments and local governments need to invest, at least for a foreseeable period, a lot more in creating environments where people can live in relative safety. Otherwise, they will settle down wherever they can, and it becomes more and more difficult to uphold very often very good local regulations. Yes, it's illegal, but the volume of it and the expanse of these settlements does not have a simple problem. It's not a simple solution of legality or not. You have to create options for people, and those options need to include access to work and public transport to get to work. Otherwise, there are no options,
right,
because people want to live.
Yeah, Margareta Wahlström, sorry to cut you off, but thank you very much for joining us on GMT from Geneva. Let's take a look.